You are probably aware of the tale of the Canadian family that wanted to move to the safest place in the world, a place free of all military threats. They did extensive research and then moved to the Falkland Islands around 1981 because they knew it was a super safe, isolated place, far from strife and conflict. United Press International reported that Canadians, Bill and Barbara Curtis and their two children left Mission, British Columbia, in September to seek a quiet life in the Falkland Islands. That didn't turn out to be a wise move at the time because shortly after, on April 11, 1982, the Falkland War began. The Curtis family have received quite a bit of unwanted publicity about the irony of their chosen destination. I have learned that there are quite a few other tales of people moving to the wrong places at the wrong times. Guadalcanal in the Solomon Islands, just before World War II, being one that jumps to mind for some reason. The point is, the safest place for any human is fundamentally unpredictable, as peace on Earth can never be guaranteed. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. You are here for your daily dose of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Please take a second to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to also hit the notification bell. Thank you. We human beings generally feel safe in our own house, in our own country with our own people and our own surroundings. But that is not the way we are supposed to live our life. The world is huge, and it poses numerous challenges and opportunities to excel in our life. Facing these challenges and winning is the best way to live our life. If you can find a country where the police don't feel they need to draw their guns every time they approach a parked car, then that's an indication of how safe that place is. If you don't need more than one lock on your front door, then that's a sign of a safe place. If people are friendly, helpful, and neighborly, then you've found a safe place. If you can go into a government agency and get help without bribery, then you are in a safe place. If you are in a country that isn't prone to having natural disasters, or if it does, there are sufficient support services to help you get over them, then you have found a safe place. If you are not afraid to travel on public transport or walk the local streets after dark, then you have found a safe place. If you have clean water and sanitation services, and adequate medical services, if you do get sick, then you are safe. It depends on what you need to be content and where you are in life. As we see in the news, there is no place on the planet where we are not subject to natural disasters or lunatics with guns and bombs. Quoting from the French philosopher, Sartre, "Hell is other people." For me, that would mean a quiet village in the mountains anywhere where we would still have Wi-Fi and not far from a mid-sized city. A place to live in peace, to read, to create. But in the case of global conflict or World War III, the safest places where to hide would probably be remote islands with no border or maritime disputes, low crime rates, relative stable economy, lack of internal, racial or political conflicts and not many fatal natural hazards. Some examples I would give are Svalbard Island, Greenland, Iceland, Madeira Island. Despite that, some more populous places are very safe and include Switzerland and Luxembourg. New Zealand would also be a safe country, and Australia, very close behind. You want to think about strategy. Logistics always comes first. As well defended as Switzerland is, the oldest form of taking a defensive structure would inevitably destroy them. Switzerland is almost entirely dependent on imports for its food. There simply isn't enough fertile ground to support its population of 8.3 million. Do you want to beat Switzerland? Starve them. They can hide behind their broken bridge, rock-covered mountain roads, fallout shelters, and armed forces all they like. But without food, Switzerland is screwed. Without food, it wouldn't take more than a few months before Switzerland is forced to surrender. Australia has a massive natural advantage. Australia is surrounded by water. Australia also has no nearby foreign deep seaports capable of staging an amphibious assault. This means that any amphibious task force would require massive supply chains, which would be very difficult to maintain and defend. Australia has a small but highly motivated and experienced defense force of 58,000 personnel. But these guys are who you really need to worry about. These bastards are unbeatable. If the attackers make it to Australia, well, guess what? You have probably just reached northern Queensland or Darwin. That's all the way in whoop whoop middle of bum nowhere. The next closest major urban center would be Brisbane, and that's 3,424 kilometers from Darwin. Also, guess where Australia keeps a decent chunk of their defense force? Darwin. Wink wink. Do you want to lay siege to Australia? You are on the right path. But unfortunately for you, their land abounds with nature's gifts. Australia has abundant fertile land to farm. More than enough to be self-sufficient. As for nukes. Yeah, the country is so big that if you wanted to destroy all of Australia, then you would throw enough fallout into the atmosphere you would inevitably doom Earth. We all die in that scenario. In essence, to achieve a successful landing on mainland Australia would be a logistical nightmare. To capture anything important would require a miracle. New Zealand shares very similar characteristics to Australia. But New Zealand is even further away from everything else. New Zealand has a disadvantage due to their smaller size, but their distance factor makes up for this. Australia and New Zealand have enjoyed a very strong relationship since their creation, and getting to New Zealand would mean facing the wrath of the entire Australian Defence Force as well. Also, many people outside of the Commonwealth don't even know New Zealand exists. New Zealand is the most low-key country there is. And good relations with pretty much everyone helps New Zealand quite a bit. The New Zealand government already understands their defensive position, which is why they have a tiny defense force of 11,440 personnel, but their measure is similar to that of Australia's defense force personnel. Finally, to emphasize the effectiveness of the ANZAC forces, I'll leave this quote. If I had to take hell, I would use the Australians to take it and the New Zealanders to hold it, said Erwin Rommel. And how about Iceland? It is undeniable that Iceland is one of the safest countries in the world, with a remarkable reputation, having been ranked first on the list for 10 consecutive years. With a very low index of global security index of 1.111. Iceland has a very low kill rate and a very small number of inmates. In addition, as an archipelago, it makes Iceland no problem with any country as it has no boundaries. So this country should be on every prepper's list. Iceland is hundreds of miles away from any other land, so it shouldn't be a target in a World War III scenario. What's more, it's a great spot for fishing, so survivors would have an abundant food supply to keep them going until the world is rebuilt. Iceland is a safe and beautiful country, which could be a lifesaver in the event of World War III. The Isle of Lewis. This Scottish island is self-sufficient and situated 3 hours away from the mainland. Simply put, it's a nice enough place to live without attracting any attention to yourself. Antarctica. It may be a bit nippy, but in a worst-case scenario, you'd probably be safe if you managed to carve out a life in the continent's barren wastes. Another frozen destination, the continent's harsh climate, means it's hard to survive there but also not a target. Yukon. One of Canada's most remote regions, the Yukon province, is well off the grid. To make matters even better, it's a mineral-rich area that is jam-packed with wildlife, meaning you could get rich and eat well whilst waiting for the apocalypse to blow over. Guam. An easily defensible island with a strong military presence, Guam is a wise place to hole up if you want to survive a worldwide conflict. Tristan da Cunha. This British collection of islands is one of the remotest places on Earth and is a top fishing spot. I cannot think of a better place to spend the end of the world than on a stunning island paradise in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And how about if you get stuck in the USA and cannot leave? Which are the safest places in the USA? Wyoming is probably the safest state in the US. In Wyoming, there are so few people and so few cities that crime is negligent. The majority of people in Wyoming own weapons, so there is little crime. People in Wyoming are very welcoming because of the vastness of the state. And why not Kansas City? In the event of non-nuclear war, this is the place to be. The city is surrounded by fertile farmland and is the ideal spot to defend against attackers. Contrary to popular belief, New York is exceptionally safe. Any city really, if you go into the countryside you're much more likely to get shot. The farther south you go, the more hospitable people are, the Midwest is flat, and you can get leveled by a tornado, the East gets massive blizzards and hurricanes, Louisiana, Gulf of Mexico states get a ton of big storms and hurricanes. The East Coast is full of earthquakes and is literally breaking off. Seattle is just rainy, but beautiful. The states are vast and riddled with danger, just like Russia, but everyone is kind and willing to help. Many places are safe in the USA, but one needs to think of their socioeconomic status. Many parts of the states are redlined or segregated to neighborhoods based on their race and ethnicity, which is intertwined with a person's economic status. Also, don't let the gun violence issue freak you out. Yes, Getting blown away by a semi-automatic is tragic, but the media also blows things out of proportion. The truth is, we should be more afraid of eating too many cheeseburgers. Let me know in the comment section below, which country or place you believe is going to be the safest in the case World War III starts. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like. Share. Leave me a comment. Subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels, I do upload videos there too. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you wholeheartedly to all those of you who have already donated. Stay safe and healthy, friends.